Solution for this exercise, we need to create a chart showing revenue costs and the EBITDA percentage. Our numbers are being shown though, revenue positive, cost negative, makes it quite hard to compare graph. So we're going to set up new charting data, and the revenue will be as simple as just go look at that cell there. Cost equals minus that cell there, just so we can see it as a positive, and the EBITDA percentage, we'll just pull it through there so we won't recalculate it. I'm going to copy it and paste it. What I now can do is graph it. So one way is I'm going to highlight that, hold control and highlight all of those, insert, set up the column chart. So that's fine, it's coming through like that. So again, we can see that it seems to be okay, but we're missing this EBITDA percentage. So I'm just gonna right click on one of these, say change series chart type. You'll see for some reason it's actually got the graphing date in here, so you can see that we don't have the years. So let's actually just fix that, right click, go to select data. This thing that says graphing data shouldn't be in here, we're gonna remove it, but it should be in the horizontal axis. So I'm going to say edit this and highlight that, because that's what I want to see at the bottom here, and you can see it's doing it there, which is perfect. I'm going to say okay. Let's go back in here, right click, change series chart type. We know the EBITDA percentage must be on the secondary axis, and we also would prefer if it was a line chart. So I'm going to say okay. So we're getting closer. What we would like to do as well is we want these column charts to be slightly overlapped. So the way we do that is we can right click on one of these and say format data series, and you'll see you've got the ability to overlap. So I'm just going to drag it a little bit to maybe 25%, maybe not enough. Let's do sort of 52%. Okay, so there what we've got is we've now overlapped it. Maybe just one or two last things. Let's change this to EBITDA, and this time we're going to do it manually. So I type it in, and here these numbers here, I'd like to see them in millions. These numbers are just too big. I'm going to right click, format axes, and you'll see we'll say display units, and we will choose millions, and there we have our chart.